using the octocopter or the UAV to assist our pest management program. So we can see those hot spots where the insects or diseases are starting earlier perhaps than just by walking the fields and scouting the fields.
So what we're trying to do with the aerial stuff is to try and calculate some indices. So we can take the vegetation and calculate certain numbers out of the pictures and see if we can be able to predict the start of the disease from those pictures, right? So we take a picture that was taken 4 weeks ago and we look at it and see if disease is starting in those fields. And we take a picture that was taken now and see the progress of the disease. At the end of the project, we would be able to say, okay, if we fly and we get these numbers, it means disease is about to start and we have to go out and spray. So yeah, so far we've done like 4 aerial shots this season. And yeah, hopefully by the end of the season, we'll be able to know those numbers.
Eventually, it'd be kind of nice to just sit in your office, push a button, and doors open, and drones fly, and you collect data. As you've probably witnessed today, we're a long ways from having that happen. In terms of climate change, one of the big things with climate change is year-to-year variability in weather patterns. And so, obviously, that's going to impact how the crop grows. And again, one of the neat things with this technology is we can survey on a weekly basis, on a V-stage basis, how that crop is growing. And enough years of data, we can say, okay, these are the constants, no matter how variable those weather patterns are. And these are the things that are changing due to variability in weather patterns. So potentially smarter decisions in things like disease control, which ultimately means less residues on our food. Doesn't necessarily mean we're going to have cheaper food, yeah, more plentiful food, but I think it's just all of part of the bringing technology to agriculture. This is just the next step.